Hello and welcome to this edition of Back in History. In Back in History, we take you back in time to the historical past. In this edition, we bring to you the story of the Republic of Gabon, which has had only three elected presidents since the grant of independence to the country in 1960. Gabon is a country in Central Africa. It is one of the richest countries in Africa, with its vast deposit of crude oil and other much sought-after mineral resources. Located on the equator, it is bordered by Equatorial Guinea to the northwest, Republic of Cameroon to the north, Republic of Congo to the east and south, and the Gulf of Guinea to the west. It has a population of barely 2.3 million people. Gabon was for several years colonized by France, and in the wake of the widespread agitation for the grant of independence to African countries, Gabon was granted independence by France on 16th August 1960. In 1961, it had its first elected president by name Léon Mba. Léon was born in 1902 in Libreville, Gabon. He attended a mission seminary in Gabon for his formal education and later took up employment in the colonial government at the time. He took active part in the politics of Gabon and in the independence struggle. He soon became a focal figure in the politics of Gabon and had the privilege of being nominated to occupy key offices in the country. In 1961, Mba attained the height of his political participation when he emerged as the president of Gabon. He chose Omar Bongo as his deputy. Omar was a much younger person to Mba. When age began to take a toll on Mba, he designated most of his powers to Omar Bongo, whom he trusted really much. President Léon Mba won a second term, but passed on in office on November 28, 1967. This marked the end of the life and time of the first president of the Republic of Gabon. Next came the second president, Omar Bongo. Omar Bongo was the vice president to President Léon Mba, and one would have thought that he would naturally succeed his deceased boss, but that was not the case here. The story has it that Omar Bongo had to travel to France on the invitation of the then president of the country, President Jacques Chirac, to be personally interviewed by the president of France before the reins of power could be handed over to him. It is stated that Jacques Chirac needed to be convinced before power could be handed over to Omar Bongo. Omar Bongo convinced Jacques Chirac and had the approval of France for Omar Bongo to step into the office of president. It should be recalled that France was a country that colonized Gabon, and for several years, even till date, France still has considerable influence and interest in the country. Omar Bongo ruled as president from 1967 to 2009, when he passed on to the great beyond. He had succeeded himself in power again and again, and was in the league of sit-tight leaders in Africa. He amassed so much wealth during his lifetime and had a total of 30 children, some of whom were ministers in his cabinet. At the time of his death, Omar Bongo alone had ruled as president of Gabon for an unbroken period of 42 years. Then came the third president of Gabon, Ali Bongo, son of the second president of the country, Omar Bongo. Following his father's demise, an interim government was put in place to oversee the conduct of election and transition of power to an elected president. Election eventually held, and Ali Bongo emerged as the new president and in effect the third president of the country. Ali Bongo also fell in love with power, just like his father. He remained in office from 2009 till August 2023, when he was ousted from office in a military coup. At the time of his removal, Ali Bongo had spent a total of 14 years in office as president of Gabon. He is said to have enriched himself with the public funds, and in the wake of his removal, videos of boxes of cash were seen circulating on the internet and said to have been found in the residence of Ali Bongo's son. Ali Bongo was kept under house arrest by the new military regime and was later released to go for medical treatment. While in the said house arrest, a video of Ali Bongo was seen asking his friends, in his words, to make some noise to possibly dissuade the coup plotters from the seat of power. It appears that the noise was not loud enough as the military continued their grip to power despite the call by the deposed president for some noise to be made. On the streets of Gabon, thousands of persons were seen jubilating the removal of Ali Bongo. Analysts have said that though the change in government came in a military coup, most of the citizens of Gabon jubilated for reason that the coup had brought an end to the control of Gabon by the Bongo family. From what has been narrated thus far, from 1960 to date, a period of 63 years, only 3 persons have been elected to serve as president of the oil-rich country of Gabon, namely President Leonba, President Omar Bongo, and President Ali Bongo. In some other countries where periodic elections are held every 4 years, with no one allowed to run for more than 2 terms, not less than 8 presidents would have governed such country from 1960 till date. It does appear that Gabon is a peculiar case, with its people and laws allowing for the perennial occupation of the office of president for as many years as possible. At the time of the making of this video, there is no indication about how soon the military will hand over power to an elected civilian president. Thanks for watching this edition of Back in History, and do remember to subscribe to the channel or follow the page for regular notification on every new video.